What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the MeteoritesPro plugin in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Structures in Minecraft offer a wide range of valuable items, resources, and mobs to attack, but you don't always get lucky with the amount of structures nearby. This is even more true on a server since you are fighting with other players to find items before everything is gone. Luckily, this can easily be solved with MeteoritesPro, a plugin that randomly spawns meteors in-game for players to loot. These structures rain from the sky, carrying valuable blocks, items, and even challenges. Head to MeteoritesPro on Spigot and press the Download Now button, and then save this file somewhere easily accessible for later. Head towards your Apex server panel, stop the server, and then click on FTP File Access near the top left, log in, and then head to the plugins directory. In the top left corner, press Upload, and on the next page, drag and drop the file into the upload area. Once this is 100% uploaded, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. Once that turns back online, you can join and run the /plugins command to confirm the installation. When you join, you aren't going to see anything change since you will need to configure the plugin first. That being said, if you are a server operator, you can force a meteorite to drop with the /mp-shoot name command. When it hits the ground, blocks will go flying, leaving behind a crater. By default, you have two meteorite options to select, one being fire and two being ice. Both of these have unique blocks to collect, and sometimes you'll get a barrel containing valuable items, but be prepared because as soon as you try to take that from the meteor, Guardians are going to start to spawn. To configure the plugin, first you're going to want to stop the server and then head to the world section and copy that world name. Head into your FTP file access, log in, and enter into the plugins directory, and then you can click on the MeteoritesPro folder. Afterwards, press Edit to the right of the config.yml file to reveal its contents. And in there, you can enter your world's name for the random meteorite world setting. Continue to make any other necessary changes and then click Save at the top and return to the main panel and restart the server. Just like most other plugins, there are a ton of commands to use in-game. To use them, you'll need to either be a server operator or have the correct permissions in a permissions plugin like LuckPerms. Here is a list of commands you can use, their permissions, and what they do. Like I said, there are barrels to find in the meteorites that contain valuable items. There are three of them by default, but attempting to loot them triggers a mob spawn event. If you want to stay away from that risk, they also include resources like obsidian, diamond blocks, and more, so you can focus on mining those if you want to stay away from the fight. Let's go through some of the barrel items and which monsters you might encounter. There are three default items to find inside the meteorite's barrels, an alien axe, the Arkenstone, and a meteorite diamond. They normally aren't all together, meaning you're only going to find one or two of them at once. Each item has custom enchants from Fortune 5 to Sharpness 10, but this can be changed in the config file. You can also add more to what spawns, creating a more diverse reward system for those who choose to hunt. After opening a barrel, you'll immediately see a meteorite guardian start to attack. These are the default mobs from the plugin, which spawn in iron armor and two golden axes. Luckily, only one of them spawn at a time, giving you enough time to either escape or slay them. If your plugin isn't working after installing it, double check you've uploaded it into the plugins file in the correct directory. You're also going to want to make sure you're running a plugin compatible server like Paper or Spigot, and that you're running a version of 1.14 and above. If your configurations don't seem to be applying, make sure you're hitting save and restarting the server after you make any changes. If it still isn't working, it's most likely a formatting issue. Check for any unwanted spaces, capitalization, or red X's on the left side of the file before you try and save again. If you're looking for a way to give your players more opportunity to find rare items, strong ore, and more, then this is the perfect way to do it. Meteors are always spawning, so there's always going to be something new to find. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.